off some time, just a surviving here in the mist.
Do you have a close relationship with your mother today? Are you all
I
are
haven't,
you close?
I will always be grateful to my mother.
Of course.
For the inspiration, for the encouragement, for all of that. Actually, right now, it's not easy for her because I don't want to talk about what's going on with her, but, she's comfortable in her home,
mm-hmm.
so it's difficult for her to come and see me when there's,
mm-hmm.
like, a lot of hoopla
mm-hmm.
and stuff going on, and, you know, she doesn't need to be in a crush of people and stuff like that. Not that she wouldn't be protected, but she prefers to kind of be up there.
Keep a distance.
And
but, Mariah, wherever you go, there's hoopla. You know, they say diva, they say that she travels with an entourage, and what I say about Mariah Carey is this. I remember when you came to the opening at Oprah School.
Yeah.
And the way you were with those girls. Number one, the time that you took with each and every one of those girls. Getting to South Africa is no joke. It is no joke to get there. So people don't go for a photo op.
No.
So you took the time to come. You spent the time with the girls. They went hysterical when they saw you. And then we have Mariah, who is known in the States. People say she's a diva. She travels with an entourage. She's this, she's that. Do you think that you're high maintenance? Do you think of yourself as a high maintenance person? And high maintenance doesn't have to be bad.
When
you can back it up the way you can.
I think I'm high maintenance, but I maintain my own self. That's the thing. Like, yeah, I'm high maintenance. And I'll tell you why. It's not just the diva stuff.
Uh-huh.
It's an emotional need that I have.
That's to protect yourself?
Yes, to protect
mm-hmm.
myself. But also I feel like, okay, so we were talking about side effects,
mm-hmm.
and I say, still a little protective about the people that I live inside, still a little defensive thinking folks are trying to run my life, still a little depressed inside, basically still a little depressed inside. I fake a smile and deal with the side effects because of the fact that when you go through something, first of all, you come from high school when I was not active
mm-hmm.
in the way that most people are but at that point.
Mm-hmm.
Because
when you say active,
sexually active, darling.
Listen, I went to college. I was a virgin in college.
And people
on my floor said, Gail, when you lose your virginity, please tell us. I was 18.
They said,
please tell us because we just can't believe that you're still a virgin.
Right. I was living on the Upper West Side of New York and living there from basically late 17, 18, and then to the point of my records. And people made, I've got my records or whatever. They made a big deal because I would be with, musicians that were, 25 years old. When I say be with, work with.
Yeah.
Please be clear.
Yes.
And they would be my friend who let me live with her told everybody.
Uh-huh.
So I guess they'd be like, what's up with your friend? And she was like, no, she's, I can't believe I'm talking about this, but whatever. and so... They would come up to me, I remember this one guy, Danny, came up to me and was like, you're the first person I know that made it to 19. And I'm just still a virgin. I'm like, oh, wow. I'm so glad to be known. This is before people knew who I was.
Yes.
About 6 months later, my first record came out, Vision of Love came out. But the point is, I went from really a place of being protective
mm-hmm.
Of myself to not be in a place where I would get my... And this is not a judgment about anybody else, because thank God for people who go through, the whole giving birth at a really young age,
mm-hmm.
and they never know who that's going to be. I mean,
they don't.
Talking about Sean before.
They don't.
Thank God every day that he's here, because he was born to a very young mother. And it's like, when you see that when you're a little girl, it distorts your perception of reality. And when I used to think, oh, it's normal, people have babies when they're 15.
Yeah.
And then people would say to me, that's your nephew, adults.
Yes.
And I'd be 12.
Yes.
And it was just this weird thing, because I was in kindergarten when he was born, so they were like,
How
does that work?
People would look at that and go, how does that work?
It would be very confusing.
Yeah, it would be confusing for some people.
Yeah. Others who are used to that get it, because, you know, my family moved from, like, they met, you know, were married in Brooklyn Heights, and then that's where they met, and then my parents decided to migrate to the suburbs. And
now, migrate is cut number one on E equals MC squared, by the way.
It's T-Pain, yes.
Yeah, I also like that song, too, but I mean, I just think that you are so candid and so honest in your music.
Thank
but it
you.
Seems like you've always been so in the lyrics that you write.
Thank you. There were songs that I wrote, let's say in the Daydream album, which had Fantasy and One Sweet Day, and I'm really proud of a lot of those songs, but there's one song called Looking In that a lot of people don't know, and it really says, you look at me and see the girl who lives inside the golden world, but don't believe that's all there is to see. You'll never know the real me. She smiles with a thousand tears and harbors adolescent fears. She dreams of all that she can never be. She weighs in insecurity and hides herself inside of me.
I'm thinking, you will never forget your lyrics. So you always hear about superstars being on stage and forgetting their lyrics.
That's because they don't write them.
That's true.
You gotta write them. I mean, even today, I was singing a song that I wrote in rehearsal, but come on, it was 8 and 7 something in the morning. I'm like, why am I singing this wrong right now? I never do that, but that's like your rehearsals in front of 1,000-plus people, or whatever.
But I like what you say, that you basically make no apologies for being high maintenance, and you say it is a way of protecting yourself. But I want to say one thing about Mariah. With these girls in South Africa,
yeah, I'm sorry that I cut you off and went on 2010s. I know the editing. Sorry, whoever's editing this.
No, but
don't hate me.
No, I think it's important for people to know this about you, because after she meets the girls in South Africa, months later, Mariah Carey sends all of these girls bathrobes with butterflies on them. And, you know,
I need a logo.
And it had the logo of the school, individual bathrobes that they wear to this day for movie night. And Oprah made such a big presentation for it. But, I mean, it just speaks to the heart of the person that you are. Aside that I would think many people don't know, because they see Mariah Carey. She walks in with an entourage of people. And I like how you say, yes, I am. I'm very high maintenance.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I am.
I am, because it's, you know.
Oh, I actually do know. Listen.
I know you do.
Listen, I'm not criticizing. I understand.
But you know what? I would think
it would be, men would be scared of you, Mariah.
I think that some of them would be.
Mm-hmm.
Most of them would be. And that's why I try to be candid, and I try to be forthcoming when we're discussing things. And, if a guy is trying to talk to me, I'd be like, look, this is me. Not
this is me, Mariah Carey.
This is me.
Yes.
MC, this is me. And most people don't even call me by my given name. But
Don't they call you Mimi? Yeah.
And Sean always called me Mimi. Yes. And my little brother slash nephew, which technically is my little brother and nephew.
But what we're going to say, this is funny.
This is funny because I will say to them, if we get to this point in a discussion, I'll say everything to freak them out, just to see what they do.
Like?
Not even to freak them out, because I don't want them to think that's my tactic. I'm actually being honest with
them.
Like, I feel like I'm a needy person in terms of, like, emotionally, because I don't think I ever felt unconditional love except from God.
Mm.
And that's a tough act to follow.
Mm-hmm.
Let's face it. And I have to say that my fans also give me, like, an incredible amount of support and unconditional love.